Hey guys, good afternoon, December 9th, 2012. Well, the house is looking ugly. Got everything tarped, snow, everything looks dead. Truck's got snow in the back, even got tarp on the trailer to keep snow out of it, so I have to pull it out, it's not full of ice. I just did a load test on my generator, well, my second generator. Just a unit I bought that wasn't running. It's now it runs perfect. A new carburetor, fuel filter, which I never had before. Runs perfect. I also tuned this thing up. May give it all its maintenance, grease. Check the squirrel gear there for proper fluid. Lubricated it, everything. Mobile worn my $10 quart. Put grease on the tracks. The squirrel cage. The squirrel gear works good, whatever they call it. What I think we're gonna do is we're gonna. It's definitely a cold start. It hasn't been started since, I don't know, last week sometime. See? Cold. Gonna turn the choke on. Well, let's check if we got gas first. Yeah, I see it splashing. I know it's got oil because I just changed it. Yep, on the full mark. Brand new Mobil 1. Get a couple primes. Turn the throttle up a little bit. Not much. I replaced the light too. That's why I really want to start because the light was blown. Uh-oh. There we go. Alright, we got a winner. The light's working. Started faster and it's had 7 months. Brand new light, 1156. The old basic tail light. Backup light, whatever you want to call it. Running good. Turn it up a little bit. Put the auger on. Here we go. Pull out the weave. Let's put the heaters on. Oh yeah, here it goes. I bought those. First year I had it, so I bought it. It didn't have the drip heaters and it didn't have the headlight. And I ended up getting frostbite in my hands. It was like negative 20 out Celsius Fahrenheit. And I got frostbite in my hands. Right across the whole hand, handle mark. So let's shut her down. That's a runner. I bought that machine brand new, I believe in 2004. Brand new. Maintained perfectly since day one. I ran regular conventional oil for the first year. After that, all Mobil 1 synthetic. Recommended from Briggs. Below 40 degrees, they recommend 530 full synthetic. So that's what I'm going to run. That guy there's got 3 weight, but luckily he's in the shop where it's nice and warm, so it's actually started. Now this thing, got a problem with the S10. Starts up, then it runs for a little while, and then it loads up like she's flooding and stalls. She won't start again. First I thought it was frozen fuel lines. I put some stuff in the tank, that's it. Well, apparently it's not it. When I got above freezing, I still got issues. It runs real good, and then it loads up. I'm not sure if it's a throttle sensor or what. Something's up. Anybody knows? Should be a PM. I'd like to know. It's a 4.3 Z motor, 1993, with a 4L6D automatic. If you know, let me know. I'd like to figure it out. And I'll go ahead and the shop manual too and dig into it a bit. Look at that trailer. Doesn't everything look terrible? And look at that neighbor. Not even her boat, it's a grandkid's boat. And next one on the right is a camper. I mean, God, why don't you just stuff everything at grandma's house? You know, she won't mind, she can't see it anyway. Hey, what about the neighbors? Oh, God. Well, stop complaining, right? Sun's going down, it's nearly 4 o'clock. People out shopping. Not me, I don't got no money. But this is New England, December 12th, 2009. Like 2 weeks till Christmas. Believe it. And what? Well, I don't know. Alright guys, thanks for watching. If you know anything about the Chevy, give me an update. There's more to come. I gotta give you a simplicity update on this, well, it's a snapper update on the motor. I got the motor broken down a bit. And we're getting ready to do a little more. Hey, thanks for watching.